back in the dinosaur world. Haven't been here in a little while. I've been actually in another country for it was 4 days that I was gone. I went to Minecon convention, and now I've got this amazing new cape to replace my Optifine cape. Now, the green doesn't really match with anything that I wear, but then again, neither did the red, so I think that it's okay. If I take off everything else, there you go. There you can see me, in case you haven't seen me in other videos and stuff. So, a nice little cape. It has a piston on it, one of the redstone pistons. I like it. I like it a lot, so I will keep it on at all times. And okay, so what I wanted to do in this video was basically just a tiny bit of building, not a whole lot. I want to get the groundwork going for just this section, I guess. Maybe go like this too. Like that. Because I did go and I collected a bunch of this stone brick. I smelted it all up. So now I can go kind of like that and make that look sort of nice. And I want to do this same kind of theme with the water and everything. Eh? Did I step on that? Guess I did. I thought that I only came to here, but I guess I did. I want to continue the same theme, the water theme, all the way across. So what I have to do is make a bunch of these flat stone slabs and then get buckets of water like this and just go all the way along and finish that up to about here. So actually, I could probably make that. Yep. Good. Piggy, how you doing, pig? Okay, and then I'll do something here. I haven't decided what yet. The observation deck is supposed to go up here, but I don't know. I just can't make it look right, and I just don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I thought of maybe doing kind of what Jurassic Park Operation Genesis does, and kind of just do like you can go out and they'd be like a big round, maybe half moon type of thing, like a giant half circle viewing platform that I can just walk around and see everything from, sort of like that, but down here. That might be a good idea. I don't know. I really don't know yet. Until I do it, I don't know. And I also finished this up a tiny bit. I dug this hole in the mountain finally. Don't really know what was holding me back from doing that, but I've done it, and now I've just obtained the blocks to finish it a little bit. I can hear a zombie. I can hear a zombie. What the heck? That's not supposed to be how. What? And those guys down there, they're always down there in that corner, that one corner. I'm not too sure why. And when I go into that corner, that's when they die. They tend to, like, just get suffocated in the wall or something, or I don't know. And that guy, what's he do? Is he might be going after Mr. Mockingcow, perhaps, because they're kind of. Or maybe that pig. I see a pig right there that he kind of. He's jumping real close to. But no, the pig's over there now, and he's still in the corner, so. Maybe Mr. Mockingcow? Mocking them even though he can't see them? He is a smooth roller. Okay, so what I wanted to do was sort of continue. Oops, continue this theme as well. And go along like so. How's it going, Mr. Mockingcow? Okay, and then I do believe I have to go over here and look. Let's see how this is done, this one. It went to just before that wall and then went across. Okay. So this will be for the other, the winter raptors, as I call them. Let's see, where are we at? Eh? Okay, hold on. There we go. This will help me kind kind of better understand how it goes. Okay. So it does, oops, it does go to here. Like that. All right. And like that. Don't want to mess up the lighting. So across we go. And I will run out of blocks, I'm sure, but that doesn't matter to me, really. I can hear a zombie in the ground right here. It annoys me to no extent. Okay. Like that. I think is proper. And when we do that, maybe I will have enough blocks. This is amazing. I can actually finish this in this episode. That is so cool. All right. That is awesome. Okay. So now the only thing that I really need to do is place those logs around, which I do not have. I'll have to get some logs and place them down all around, and then that'll be done. Place some trap doors around the sides. Yep. It'll be cool. It'll be very nice. Oh, yeah, and... yeah, and that's about it, I think. I was thinking of maybe making these walls... yeah, I'll make them birch again, too. Why not? These guys can just stay there for now. Alright. So that's that. I eventually do want to have a third raptor pen right over here. As you know, for the three different types of raptors. So, that'll be something to work on. Now, I wanted to go and show you guys the development of our Spinosaur. Yes, our Spinosaur. It's still alive, thankfully. I'm just going to actually... oopsie. Didn't want to put that right there. I'm actually going to put these in the chest here and those as well. And those as well, because I'm going to come back for them and start building in there, and it might as well be here. Okay, so I'm going to go to our Spinosaur. Running. I really need to finish like a path down to here, I think. Just to make it look nice. It is dark here. What? Has it always been that dark there? I can't really tell. I'm still using the game without the shader pack. And everything just seems darker to me. I don't remember there being spots like that, so... I don't know. Something might have changed. Not sure what, though. Video... lighting is maximum. Brightness is bright. Yeah, I guess it's still fine, but... I don't know. Weird things. Uh-oh. Where did he come from? Just on this little ledge here, I think. There we go. So I kind of mentioned it near the beginning, or actually as I was looking at the observation deck possibility, that Operation Genesis, Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, is still... episodes are coming out. So if you haven't checked it out yet and you're a dinosaur fan, definitely check it out. Because it seems to be a very good series. A lot of you guys really, really enjoy it. New viewers and old ones alike. So if you haven't checked it out, we're on episode 3 or so by now. Maybe 4 by the time you watch this. I don't know. Maybe more by the time you watch this. Check it out. It's on the channel. Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. And we're having fun. I'm having a lot of fun playing that. So... I will definitely be continuing the series, so check it out. First, let's stop and take a look at this Tyrannosaur. He's 2 days old still. That's good. Still healthy. No complaints. Let's check out the Spinosaur. Spinosaur has grown. He's now 1 day old. And so far has not died. So I think... like, I tried to push it into... I tried to push it into the fence just to see how it would fare, but I don't think I can really tell until it's a little bit bigger. Like when it's fully grown, then I think I'll be able to tell more about how it'll move into walls. And then I can maybe place down the water again. I haven't placed the water down, and I won't until it's just a little bit bigger than he is now. Maybe 3, 4 days old, maybe up to 5 days old. I don't know. We'll try, like, well, I'll let it grow out pretty big before I put water down, just so that it doesn't drown. Let's check its. It could eat, and I've got 14 fish on me, so eat away. Did it eat it all? Yes, it did. It's now full. So that's good. Let's see, okay. So when it's in the wall like that, its shadow is still there, which I think is good. I hope that's a good sign. Oh, and I haven't finished the fence, as you can see on the other side. There's still a tiny bit of fence that needs to be done. I don't need that much wood in order to do that either, so I should finish that, but enough is enough with the building. What's in here? Nothing. Alright. So enough is enough with the building. Let's get on to the next area. So I am actually going to go and fly to the other dig site, because I think in the next few episodes and stuff. And such, I'd like to get more DNA and different dinosaurs. I know that a lot of the people that you guys watched that are doing the dinosaur mod, some of them have different dinosaurs now, and I am totally 100% jealous. I admit it, I am jealous because I have wanted and I have waited and I have tried to get new DNA. And yes, I could cheat one in, but that wouldn't really be fair. I wouldn't be honest, and I'm an honest kind of person. So I will do it the proper way, and I will just keep digging for fossils, keep getting those biofossils and analyzing them and hoping that one day I'll get one of the new fossil types. One of the new DNA types, I should say. Do 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 do. How you doing, Raymond? How you doing, Raymond? Calling from on top of a mountain. Are you okay? Yeah. Okay. I think he's okay. He needs a shaving though. It's still pretty warm out. He grows his hair so fast. He grew his hair really fast. I don't know why. I think it's like a sheep. He just ate something and his hair instantly grew back. Maybe. Kind of cautious about that skeleton I saw a second ago. I don't want it to come down and hit Blueberry because she is extraordinarily still. Only got 10 hearts left, so. I don't know. I need to make a healing potion. I understand that. I know I need to make a healing potion. So maybe that will be one of my tasks at the new dig site is to work on a healing potion, but that won't happen until I first learn how to make a potion and then second get all the materials for a potion. Now, the writing of Blueberry has always, for me, I really enjoy it. It's really awesome. I know that it does need some improvements. And I mean, if you are like me and you have a Pixelmon thing going, if you haven't checked out my Pixelmon series and you like Pokemon and stuff, check out my Minecraft Pokemon. Plug in all my different episodes now. Just like this one, it's perfectly clean and no language and cool stuff going on. Check it out. And what they just did in there is they updated the Charizard, as well as other Pokemon as well, but the Charizard, for example, you can fly on it and it just looks so cool. The flying animation is just so intense, so awesome. So, I mean, I really hope that eventually this mod can fully be realized and updated to that point too. That would be just so amazing. Because what the Pixelmon mod has kind of started to do is go for their ultra realism. Like, everything looks more realistic now. All the graphics are rounded and smooth, and textures are really nice textures. And this one's still kind of blocky, which I don't mind. I mean, that's, you know, it's Minecraft after all, but it would be nice to see HD textures on the dinosaurs and stuff. Just for my personal preference, I think that would look really cool. But doesn't mean that it has to be that way. Can still look blocky and still look good, so I honestly don't mind it too much. There's my little palm tree to tell me that I am in the right place, so I will start to land. We start to land, and here we go. We are at the new dig site. There we go. And I am back at Isla Muerta. Right? Yeah, Isla Muerta. Where our dinosaurs are nice and growing big and strong and all that kind of stuff. How you doing? Very good. A little bit hurt. Something happened to you, guy? Gotta feed it, maybe. What does it eat? Sugar, cookies, apples. I don't have either of those things. Any of those things. What about our Mosasaur? Whatever happened with our Mosasaur? Oh, look at that. Yeah. Oh, no. Little Mosasaur is in the water. Oh, no. Look at it. Yikes. Oh, no. Ouch. Hey. That is not cool. That is not fun. How you doing? 0 days old. Could eat. Needs to eat. Would like to eat. Ouch! It wants to eat me, apparently. Does it not want... Oh, God. Does it eat them? No. I've forgotten. I think it eats Nautilus and stuff, but... Ouch! What? I am sitting on the shoreline. And it's a block underneath me. And it has actually managed to hit me on a couple occasions here. Oh, see? That is insane. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Oh, don't kill me. Do not kill me. I just want to collect the fish because that is actually like a fish generator. And my Spinosaur would appreciate some fish. Look at it. Just going crazy. It is fast, too. Anyway, I don't think you're safe, cow. I just don't think you're safe. Stay away from those waters. But I'm not sure how to feed the Mosasaur. And I know that I had a few suggestions, you know, people saying, well, it eats Nautilus. And then I'd put Nautilus, like, right beside it. Or even try to, like, force feed it. Nautilus, and it won't eat Nautilus. Then people are saying, well, it needs squid, so you need to make a pond big enough for squid. And it doesn't eat squid. I've seen squid in there, and it doesn't eat the squid. It just, for some reason, doesn't want to eat. At least that's the one back home. Okay, so what we got in here? Cow, pig, triceratops, ankylosaur. And we got a Spinosaurus egg in there, and that's about all that we care about. That's all that we care about. Okay. Excuse me. Now, what I could do with this Spinosaur is something kind of evil, something kind of mean. I was thinking of actually releasing a Spinosaur into the wild and seeing what effects that might have. Whether or not it would attack pigs and stuff. I'm curious about what that would do, what it would do. So I might do that. I know that it might be a pretty crazy idea to put a Spinosaur in the wild. It is definitely not a very nice and tame and mild-mannered, kind-hearted creature. It is evil. It is pure evil. But I am very tempted to try it, so I think that is exactly what I will do. Let's place it right there and see what happens. Now, I'm not going to be around for when that spawns. I am just going to dash away. There are a lot of animals out here that it might try to eat. I don't know if it will or not. I hope it doesn't wander back here and then kill all my dinosaurs. That would be a disaster, but sometimes outbreaks happen, as you guys know. So, what I'm gonna do, I might. Should I go down right now and start digging for fossils? I know that. I can't believe it. I get the demand for fossil hunting a lot more than you would. Than I would expect, anyway. You guys might expect it, but. I don't know. I don't watch anybody else on YouTube, so I don't really know what other YouTubers are doing in their series, whether they go caving a lot, whether they don't. I really don't know. To be honest, I just stick with what I do on my own. I don't pay attention to others. And that's the way it's gonna be. But where is some wood here? I would like to know anyway, whether or not they cave a lot, like do a lot of caving and stuff. Maybe they do. Maybe that's why people like it a lot. I don't know. Take that and put that into. Oops, not into there. Okay. There we go. Cook some potatoes. Potatoes are good for you. Okay, and the rest. Get a bow on the barb, why not? Make some torches, perhaps. And then I need that wood, and then we're good to go. Then we can go caving. See if we can find anything new. Let's see, I'll just go way over here. Look at the ferns! Oh, maybe it wasn't a good idea. Maybe it wasn't a good idea. This is where you could put some kind-hearted herbivores. Let them just graze in the ferns and stuff. That would be kind of cool. I know that a lot of people have wanted that. They want me to go to an island and just release a whole bunch of different herbivores and stuff. I might. We'll see. All right, there we go. That'll be enough wood to get me past the cold, dark nights down in the dungeons below. And while we're down there, I can search for fossils. Now, I think I'm gonna go down that cave there instead of my big cave entryway there. How are you doing, Ankylosaur? I didn't even really look at you. Wow, doing very good. Eats raw potatoes, huh? 6 days old. You're an old fella. Getting old. Okay, so I got my efficiency pick, which I will use. Look at all this. Coal, as you know, is very good for torches and things, so I like to grab it when I am down in a cave. Go. This is amazing. So I'm very happy that my Spinosaur is growing at a normal rate. Seems like the old one, the one that died, took a long time. I don't really know why. Maybe because I wasn't near it very long. For some reason, it just took a long time, to grow. So this one seems to be okay so far. No complaints. Chicken egg. Boop. Okay, I'm just looking for darkness and that kind of thing. As you guys know, I never get all the fossils all of the time when I go down into a cave. I often miss a lot of the fossils. So I often run back into a cave the same way that I went before, just so that I can see, oh, look, there's a whole bunch of fossils kind of thing. I hear that zombie. I hear you. Where are you? Where'd you go? I saw him. He had a shovel or something. There's a cow down there! Hello, Mr. Cave Cow! Mr. Mining Cow? Oh, yeah. I hear a skeleton, too. Oh, this is all dark. Okay, that's good. Mr. Mining Cow, how's your mining going? Huh? Looks like you're a little bit stuck there. There we go. Saved Mr. Mining Cow. Ooh, I'm collecting a bunch of mushrooms. Okay. Not really seeing any fossils yet, which is actually maybe a good thing. Means that I was thoroughly through here, but I even went into the dark area. Didn't find any there. There's a creeper. Oh no! I didn't get my second hit in. Oh, my boots stay strong. Stay strong, boots. Is that the same cow? Mr. Mining Cow, you're just too good at this. You are fast. Beat me down here. I'll never be as good as a pro like you. Okay. Where? Yeah, this is all mined up already. I might actually have to go to a new place. Just because otherwise this is all done. This is taken. This is good. Oh, wait. No, I remember. There was a big section here that I had not finished looking at. I thought it was like in this direction, maybe. How do I get there? I remember it. It was a big section. I remember. I remember now. I gotta get out of this cave. I gotta go down into a different cave. Slightly different. They're probably kind of related. They're really close to each other, but I think I know where to go. Okay, I'm gonna get up this way. Yeah, this way. Ooh, it is dark. That is bad. That is terrible things. Okay. I'm ready for a battle. Three skeletons, and I saw a creeper as well. Oh, God. And a spider. Okay. Well, I certainly haven't been down here. There's fossils and bad things. This isn't the place that I wanted to go, though. Look at that! First one was biofossil. That is sweet. This isn't the cave that I was gonna go down, but hey, if it has fossils, I'll take it. I will gladly go down. Look at all of that. Four biofossils already, and this is our first little batch of fossil. That is amazing. This is a good day. Sometimes I can go for like 30 minutes without finding anything at all of interest. Okay. And there. Look at that! Seven already. I'm happy. I am so glad that we're getting fossils like that. Because that's usually once every eight or so biofossils, you get one DNA. So, or one thing of interest, like maybe, I don't know, plant fossil type of thing. One in every eight. So the fact that I've got 9 of them already? Wow. That is incredible. Here's a suggestion for the mod developers, and I don't know if it's possible, but this is something kind of like what the Pixelmon mod did for their Pokemon rates. I wondered if it would be a possible thing to have like an accessor method or an accessor, yeah, it's called methods in Java, like some kind of a way of grabbing the value of the, oh, actually, it would be mutator method. What am I talking about? Programming 101. The ability to modify the values of the spawn rates for things like biofossils and relic scraps and such, so that the user would actually be responsible for how much something spawns. I mean, the benefit of that would be that people like me would stop complaining about, I never find any biofossils. Because I could set it up to, like, say, a 30% chance or something huge like that of dropping a relic, a biofossil, I should say. I think that would be cool. I wouldn't set it as high as 30%, that would be a little bit too high. I don't know what it's set to right now in percentage wise. I imagine it's a pretty low percentage, though, considering all the different items that drop. But right now I'm being just very lucky. I got 11 so far, and the small amount of fossils we found, I think that's guaranteed DNA, at least one. But yeah, what about a mutator type of thing that lets you change the variable for the drop rate, if that's even possible? I don't know how the whole thing works. I could be just mumbling to myself and not making any sense. But it might be kind of an interesting idea. Interesting concept. Okay. Ran out of torches, so I gotta make a couple more. I'll make a stack. There we go. And I think this is now the cave. If I go past here, oh, maybe not. Thought I was where I was supposed to be. Maybe it's up here. I should be close to where I need to go, where the new stuff is. Maybe down here. Yeah, I think it's down there. 'Cause that's the ravine, right? Yeah. Yes. Okay, so it's all new basically past here. And all new down here as well. So I'm gonna drop. Okay, nothing gonna shoot me off of here, kill me. I don't know. I feel like with a diamond pickaxe or something, it's giving me more biofossils than usual. Like, why is it giving me so many? I just don't understand. I must be just really lucky today. Found 14 already. That's crazy. Like, relic scraps, I've only found 5, and usually they're about 50-50, like the same. I don't know. No, good. Now all I'll find is relic scraps, I bet. Yeah, maybe it's normal. Maybe I'm just overreacting. Okay. No, just coal. Iron. Not gonna get all the iron that I see. I got a lot of iron. Here we go. Only the one? Okay. Ooh, there's some more down there that I didn't see. Okay. This is great. This is so awesome. I'm so happy that I'm getting all the biofossils. Hello, Mr. Skelly. Hello, Skelly's friend. Oh, crap, there's a creeper too. Ah, couldn't place torch. He missed. Ugh. hear another skeleton as well. I'm running past fossils just to place torches down. Make it brighter. Okay. It's all bright for as far as I can see. Yes, alright. Back to mining up fossils and stuff. The plans that the mod developer have are just amazing, some of them. I've heard so many different things, and even the stuff that the fans have said in terms of like what they want to see for the archaeology side, and that, it's just awesome. The community for this mod is pretty cool, pretty amazing. If you guys want to get involved, you can go onto their GitHub and make your own suggestions and stuff. If you find bugs, report them there. You can check out the link for it is in the MinecraftForum.net page for this mod. I don't know the actual URL address off the top of my head. If I did, that would be nuts. Oh, there's a creeper that spawned right there in my path. Now he's coming to say hello. Well, hello, creeper. Ouch. Okay. Need to get rid of this lava bit. Okay. Oops. How does this go? What am I doing? I don't even know anymore. Ah! There we go. Just wanted to get rid of the water. I ended up building a wall. I can hear zombies. Means that there's maybe more cave under here. Certainly no fossils under here. But yeah, go check out the developer's GitHub. And I keep saying GitHub, assuming that you guys know what it is. GitHub is basically a website where you can log in and post different things. Mostly their bug fixes or bug reports and stuff. Oh, I didn't know that these two kind of linked up. That's cool. I went down there before. I'm gonna just pillar my way up. Yeah. There we go. Okay, now I can go down this away. Huh. I hear a zombie like right in my ear, but I don't see a zombie. There he is! Look at that creeper right there. Okay. Well, it looks like my luck has run out. Now I'm not finding very many biofossils at all. I hear a skeleton! Oh no, it's not a skeleton, it's a zombie! That kind of scared me a little bit. Oh, made me jump, made me have those panicky feelings. Oh. I expected there to be a skeleton, and it didn't look like a skeleton, so my brain freaked out. Okay. Oh, relic scrap. Yep, I guess my luck ran out. Like I said, they're usually about equal, and 16 to 11, that's pretty equal. So much for there being a lot of biofossils. But I think I'm going to end this episode here. Otherwise, it is a very long episode of me just caving. Thank you guys for watching. I will take these back up when I'm done. I'm going to run around here and maybe gather up a few more fossils and stuff. But what I will do is run back up, analyze these biofossils that I've found, and hopefully come out with something good. Ouch! Oh no! Huh? Man, that skeleton was like rapid firing. I will hopefully come out with something good. So, like the video if you like the video, which I hope you have. Subscribe if you haven't already to stay up to date with all the latest episodes and stuff. If you don't make a YouTube account to do that, please do and subscribe. Let me be your first. Why not? And do all those other awesome things that you people do. We'll be seeing you in the dinosaur world. And be sure to check out my Jurassic Park Operation Genesis as well for more dinosaur stuff. Until next time, we'll be seeing ya. Bye-bye.